Hi everybody! I hope you're all having a great day out there. It's been pretty nice today here in Albuquerque, but now the wind is kicking up. We have a cold front that's sneaking in. One last one. I hope it's the last one. It's going to be a little bit chilly, so hopefully everything that I have out will be alright. But I haven't put any of the vegetables out. Sorry about all the wind. They thought it'd be a great time to do a tour of the back garden and what's happening there. So first, I think we'll just do a swing around so you can see everything at once, and then I'll take you on a little tour. You ready? Here we go. Well, let's first say hi to Molly. Miss Molly! She hasn't been very talkative to the camera of late. Okay, so here we go. We're gonna go this corner, and we'll swing on around to the middle, to this corner, and to the side. So there you go. That's the whole thing right there. Let's come on around back. And I think we'll start going down this direction here and work our way around the whole garden so you can see what's happening. So first, as you can see right here, I'm doing a little more painting on the cement. I had it red, and now I think it's going to be beige. We'll see. I changed my mind a lot. Over here, this is the little plantain herb that I was talking about. It's growing quite well. And then a couple of roses that are doing well. And then right over here is where we have I've got the wine barrels put in and the hammock up on, what are those called? Little square tile things. Anyway, so this is where I'm going to be building a pergola, and I don't know if I'll get to it this summer or not, but the barrels, what I'm doing is I'm going to be putting the post through the barrel, and then I'm going to be putting a hole in the barrel, and that's where I'll be growing the grapes on both ends here up over the pergola that I hope I'll get in. I don't know if I'll get that built this year or not. So as we go along, our fence that we built so Molly didn't bark so much, but she still barks all the time. And then in the corner here, we've put in another evergreen tree up with the aspens. And the little aspens are starting to get their little leaves, so that's really great. One of the reasons we put the evergreen in here is to help the aspen trees. So we are, our elevation is about 5,200 feet, so we're just within a few feet of the elevation of Denver. However, because we're more southern and in the high desert, it's much hotter than Denver. And the aspen trees, they like the elevation, they don't like the wind, and they don't like the heat. And so that's why I have them in the corners of my big fences to help them with the wind. And then now we've got some evergreen trees in here that will help with the heat this summer. I also will be planting corn back here against this wall in a square, and more sunflowers, and that also will take the heat off of those little aspen trees, and hopefully that'll help them this summer because I do love them. And down here we have a little raspberry bush. I honestly am not sure how it'll do. Plant one every year. Maybe it'll make it this year. Who knows? I'll just do my best. Back here is the back of our little garden, and this year I'll be planting tomatoes, a lot of tomatoes, watermelon, and a few other goodies like cucumbers, and probably some carrots. And in the corner right there is a rose. It's a climbing rose that I hope that I'll put, that'll grow over this arbor. Now let's go back on down our steps. Also, I have some scraggly lavender in here. I had to move it again because the hose was beating it up so much. So hopefully it'll be happy there. And down here we have a bunch of lemon balm coming back up, and also the bee balm coming back up. And I have to tell you, the butterflies just love it. They've been really busy running around. So now let's go on down to the end of our path here. This is where last year I dug up all the red rock and pulled it into the middle, and then we put the grass over here and the grass over there. And then the month of March is when I moved all of the river rock in, and then put these flagstone pieces. They were in the funny circle over there, and I'll tell you more about that in a little bit. There's a little butterfly flying around. Then you've got these great big rocks that I forced my husband to go rock hunting with me for. But underneath these rocks here is a water fountain reservoir. That's where I put that. I'll have some pictures of the process of that. I'll be putting that up later this month for you to see. And then I've been planting some more Mexican feather grass going up the steps. Let's go on up the steps here. Sorry about all the wind. Let's cross over. We can see our Leland trees doing really quite well. This is a cypress. And all of our Mexican feather grass that we grew, that we put in last year, is really big. I'm really happy with it. Got the gate done. Yay! And then right here is hollyhocks. Did you know that a hollyhock seed takes a year to germinate? I should have known that. I've grown a lot of hollyhocks, but for some reason I didn't know that. So last year I put in some seeds and nothing happened. I thought, oh well, here it is, because it takes a year to germinate. They'll also self-propagate, so they'll drop seeds and you'll end up with so many hollyhocks you won't know what to do with. But I can never have enough of them. I love them so much. So, and they grow really well here in the high desert. So now we're gonna go across the back of the fake river, and you can see a really tall Mexican feather grass, and I've got a couple of little ones that I've put in, and also the row of roses that should climb up this wall. Again, the wall for keeping Molly from barking too much. And right here we have a little apple tree. This is a golden delicious, and I'm really happy that it's got some leaves. I put that in as a bare root earlier this year, so I'm really happy that it's doing okay. Right over here we have our little peach tree, which we have sort of bird netted because it has little tiny peaches on it, which I'm surprised because it's only been in for a year, so that seems a little bit early. I don't know if the bird netting will work or not, but right now we're trying. We'll see. And as we go along this pathway, here's another little peach tree, and it's just finished blooming, and there's some little places where the peaches are starting to grow, so we'll cover that one up pretty soon. And then we keep on going, and right here we have another apple tree. This is a Honeycrisp apple, and it was a bare root as well, so I'm really happy that it's looking good. I put in the Honeycrisp because the kiddo loves Honeycrisp apples, but for a Honeycrisp you have to have a companion apple tree, and the golden is a one that you can put in with the Honeycrisp because they cross-pollinate, so they have to have, if you're going to get any fruit from the Honeycrisp, it has to have a companion tree. Now, it takes a really long time before you get fruit, so I'm not sure when we'll ever get fruit on this tree, but if you don't plant it, you'll never get fruit, so you might as well plant it. So that's my theory on that. And then we're going to come on around here, and you can see these little aspen trees have got some leaves on them. Sorry, I just tripped over a rock. Sorry about that. Aren't they cute? I love my little aspen trees. And then back here in the corner, we have another evergreen tree. That's a cypress in there. And that will help those little trees as well. Now, the other reason that we have the evergreens, that I've started putting in more evergreens, is because in the winter here, we get sun year round, more than even Florida. But we don't get much snow, so we get a lot of brown in the winter, and it can get kind of wearying, you know, when you just, that's all you see. So I've started putting in a little bit of evergreen things around so that we have some color all year round. And so the cypress are great because they do really well here in the high desert. The Mexican feathergrass does fantastic, and it stays green most of the year. It gets a little yellow in the winter, but it stays pretty green. Rosemary is a great plant to put in because it gives you food. It's fantastic. It tastes good. It smells wonderful. It keeps bugs away. And it's evergreen all year. And it likes to grow here in the high desert. So that's another evergreen that I'll be putting more in. I put some more in the front. When I do a video, I'll share that with you. So let's go on around. Here I put my chairs back up here, and the little desert willow I was worried about because it's been dormant and I wasn't sure if it was going to come back, but way down there there's some little leaves starting to pop up on the trunk of it and even up here, so yay, it survived. I never know. The one in the front, it had leaves starting on it, so I knew that one was okay. And then right here is the monster huge strawberry bed. Don't ask me why I made it so big. It just ended up that way. I kind of built it, I would say, the homestead way, the way my dad taught me. It was kind of piece by piece, and it just got bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, and that's all that happened. Now most of the dirt's in it. I'm also putting mushroom compost in there. I'm getting really close, just need a couple more bags. Over here, this weird circle where the flagstone was, the reason I moved the flagstone is it looked weird, and I really thought it was in cement, but it started to kind of pop up, so I decided to pull up one and see what's under there, and it was just sand. So I felt the flagstone would have been much more effective as stepping stones going up the hill there. So that's why I moved it there. But I don't really know what I will be doing with the sand circle or the cement piece there. I still haven't decided. I've got a couple of ideas, but I'm going to have to percolate on that for a while. I think that's how the best way to do that is just kind of wait and see. A couple of things I wanted to share about high desert gardening as well is that one of the reasons I do raised beds for my back, but also because the ground here, so this backyard was full, just full of red rock and goat head stickers, just, I mean, packed. And out here in the West, they grow like crazy. And so, but they drop those little goat heads and it buries on down deep in the sand and the clay, and if you start digging that up, they're dormant, but it wakes them up, and then they start growing like crazy, and you can grow huge crops of them. They aren't much good for anything other than holes in your feet, but excuse me, allergies. So it's better not to dig up the dirt too much. I pulled everything. I don't want to use any herbicides, weed killers, or anything like that. So I've been pulling them for the last year. Also, that's one of the reasons I put in the grass, because that suppresses it. And then later, I'm going to be planting in the middle of the grass areas over time. That was one of the plans. It takes time to get it all done. And then I've done all the raised beds and brought in dirt on top of that clay soil, and which it'll eventually get on down there and you'll get really good dirt out of it, but it won't wake up the dormant, all of them. I mean, they still come up, and I still, you know, come out here and have to weed once in a while, but it's not nearly as bad as it once was. You know, last 2-3 years ago, I would have to spend days pulling weeds, and now, you know, I only spend a day once in a while getting the weeds, and bringing in mulch and bringing in compost, that all helps. So that's one of the things that I've been doing here in this earth, and things are growing and I'm really happy with it. I'm looking forward to summer. I can live on corn on the cob, watermelon, cucumbers, and BLTs all summer, and I'd be perfectly happy. Oh, and sweet tea. Gotta have sweet tea. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed the tour of the crazy garden lady's garden, and I hope you have a great night. I'll talk to you.